introduce myself very quickly. I'm a visual artist who makes a lot of money with free graphic software. Fetch is a photo batch application. If you compare it to GIMP, or it's moving away from that, or Krita, it's there you save the images. With Fetch, you save the recipes to your images. And it should be so easy to use for everyone. How do you start? You start with some simple ingredients, and Fetch has at the moment 55 of these ingredients. It's not very readable, but well, you get the impression that there are a lot of them. And the yellow ones are the ones which are new in the latest version. A big addition is write support for metadata, which doesn't allow you to not only allow you to edit metadata or delete it, but also to do advanced things like geotagging or time shifting of your pictures. Another thing is also like JPEG support. And also what's really exciting is that Fetch now allows you to interact with other powerful free graphic software. So you can, even if you don't know anything about Blender, don't worry, you don't have to open Blender. You can now use Blender through Fetch with one click of the button. The same is true for Image Magic. Everything which is possible in Image Magic is now also possible in Fetch. And also, Fetch uses certain tools of Inkscape and GIMP in the background. I will come back on that later. These are more actions which are possible. So you can pile up these ingredients into a nice recipe. And for example, what I use a lot in this presentation to eat my own dog food is here you see how it works. The first action is the round action, then it adds a reflection, then it saves the image. So that's what I use for most of my screenshots to make them look nice in the presentation. And if that's too much work for you, you can even be more lazy, because Fetch can you offer a menu of pre-cooked recipes. For example, to make batch buttons for your website, or to make a Polaroid, or to turn your images in 3D objects with Blender, and so on. This allows you to save a lot of time, because everything you can do for one image, you can also do for thousands of images, because the amount of images don't matter anymore. I will give a quick demo. You can start Fetch just from the menu. So you start by adding actions. For example, I will very quickly demonstrate, because there are so many actions you can filter the results. So we do a reflection. We put it in a perspective. And we, of course, will save it. So this is the action list to better overview what happens. So I just do a reflection perspective and a save. I can just drag and drop pictures on it, and it will batch it. And the result is saved on the Fetch folder in your on your desktop. You can change that to any folder you want. Let's say that I'm not happy with the perspective, I can click here and choose a different projection and run it again. And you have it updated here. So this is just to demonstrate how easy it is to just quickly pile up something together and apply it to any amount of pictures you want. I can also, so if you are, can also demonstrate library, then, for example, let's choose a Polaroid.
And to show it can batch images, I will drop two images on it. And then it will batch them and display them in the fetch folder. Or maybe it displays them on the desktop. So you see, with just some clicks, you can do very nice effects for a lot of images at the same time. And it will give you a nice notification in the end. You can also run fetch on the server, so it doesn't depend on the user interface. You can execute it directly, or you can prepare your action list in the user interface and run it on the server. Fetch also now has an image inspector. Before, the image inspector could only handle one image at a time, but now you can change metadata also in the image inspector of one photo or of a whole row of photos. I can maybe also give a little demonstration of that. So you open the image inspector, and I take just a photo. And I can go to the EXIF metadata. And then, for example, if I go to the date, I see it's editable. And it says Wednesday. When, for example, I change the day, you will see that the day switches to Thursday. So also, all the values are connected together. So also new in this version is that you have much more visual feedback. So you have preview dialogues of this of the mask action or for the highlight action. As I said, Fetch can now interact with the different free graphic software. So this means that it also can open much more formats. So it can open GIMP files. It can open RAW files through DCRAW. It can batch process SVG files into bitmaps with Inkscape, because if you try to do that with ImageMagick, you get very bad results, because ImageMagick can't handle the SVGs of Inkscape. And ImageMagick also allows almost any file format to be added, from movies, font files, PDF, and so on. This is an overview of the ImageMagick actions. Well, you can't read them, but I will give some examples. So the ImageMagick has its own Polaroid action, which you can use as well, or a pencil sketch action. And this is, for example, done with Blender, and you can apply that to any amount of photos you want as well. The Blender action works that you choose the object. Right now we have 6 objects. And then also with preview dialog, you can immediately choose. You don't specify the amount of degrees. You just immediately choose the viewpoint you want. If you want, you can change the axis, but that's not really necessary. And what's also new for the latest version is that we've been working on cross-platform support in our kitchen, following the human interface guidelines of each platform. So here you see the result. There's one mistake. I think Apple people will see it. The open button on the toolbar is a huge sin. You should never do that on Apple. We will remove it. They have their own rules. Here you see, for example, the notifications in action. We use in Ubuntu, we use a new notification system. On the Mac, we use Growl, and Windows doesn't have its own system, so we provide a custom solution. This is the Windows installer. It's available now. It's not publicly available because we want to get feedback from beta testers. If there are any people here still using Windows, they can get it from the Windows installer from me, the same for the Mac installer. And it's the first version started out as a private project, but now we are 3 to 4 developers. and it's growing every day. So if you want to contribute, you're welcome to join us. And yeah, I don't think there's time for questions maybe, but if there's one question, I'm happy to answer. And don't ask if there's a workshop, because it was just this afternoon.
So first we give you applause. One question. Well, Erik is getting ready. Anyone? Yes, there.
So it looks like this can be used to call other programs, but can other programs call this, for instance? Is that pretty easy to do?
That's also possible. I mean, you can do it from the command line, and also you can do it as a Python API.
That's a quick answer. Thank
okay. You.